Origen's final means of penitence and forgiveness is the one with which we Catholics are most familiar, confessing our sins to a priest. For Origen, this is no mere formality or functionality. Rather, it is the result of, as the psalmist says, "I am wearied with sighing. All night long I drench my bed with tears. I soak my couch with weeping." It is when the greatest foe we wish to see vanquished is our own sinfulness. The psalmist makes this clearer. "Then I declared my sin to you, my guilt I did not hide. I said, I confess my transgression to the Lord, and you took away the guilt of my sin." We are our own worst enemy. Naming and claiming it are critical to real forgiveness and lasting healing. It is not so much about seeing the speck in someone else's eye, but rather becoming aware of the great beam in our own eyes. This is not merely a matter of intellectual knowledge, but an awareness of what I have done or failed to do, which has had such a profound effect on me, on my neighbor, and on my relationship with God. It should and must bring us to tears, so much so that we can say, "My tears have been my bread day and night." It is this deep sense of our offenses against the good God, our offenses against our neighbor, our offenses against what it means for us to be human in the image of God. It is this deep sense which must undergird all of our approaching the sacrament of penance. Sisters and brothers, over these seven reflections, we have been following the early church theologian Origen and his positing of seven means to atone for our sins and to seek God's healing forgiveness. This ultimately leads us to the sacrament of reconciliation. However, let us always bring to that sacrament a deep contrition for our sins and a healthy desire to allow the Spirit to bring about a real conversion in our lives, such that the love of God is manifest in all we do.